Hello friends, welcome to a new lecture today on suppression of spermatogenesis. In the last class, we have learned about intrauterine contraceptive devices. In this class, let us learn about the agents which are used for suppression of spermatogenesis. The first agent which I would like to discuss is Gosipol. So this Gosipol is a male contraceptive, obviously. It is used for suppression of spermatogenesis. So this is an yellowish pigment. Which is isolated from cottonseed oil. It is an yellowish pigment isolated from cottonseed oil. Okay, what is its action? It will inhibit spermatogenesis in seminiferous tubules. That is its main action. What is its side effects? It has some side effects. So because of these side effects, its use has been limited. So the side effects include weakness, hypokalemia, that is decrease in potassium levels, or it can even cause permanent sterility. Okay, it is used in the dosage of 10 to 20 milligrams per day orally for 3 months. And thereafter, after that, we give 20 milligrams twice weekly. Okay, this is spermatogenesis suppressor Gosipol. The next spermatogenesis suppressor which I would like to look after is testosterone. The second one, which is testosterone enanthate. This testosterone enanthate, it is given 200 milligrams as an injection weekly. Okay, for nearly 6 to 12 months. What does this do? This will lead to azoospermium, that is decrease in sperm count, and as a result, it will prevent conception. There are many other drugs like which can be used which are testosterone analogs, like testosterone bucyclate or testosterone diconate. Okay, the side effects of these testosterone analogs are it can cause osteopenia, liver and lipid metabolism dysfunction. It can also cause prostate enlargement. Okay, so these are the different side effects, and because of these side effects, these are not much used. And the next drug which are GnRH analogs. Continuous administration. Normally GnRH which is there in our body, it is present as pulsatile manner. So because of the pulsatile effect of the GnRH, the hormonal level variations are seen in our body. But if we give continuous GnRH, this will decrease the sperm count and also decreases sperm motility. This will also decrease testosterone. All the hormone levels will fall in our body because of absence of this pulsatility of GnRH. The side effect of this GnRH is loss of libido and also osteoporosis. Then the next drug which is important is medroxyprogesterone acetate. Okay, this medroxyprogesterone acetate, this can be given as IM 250 milligrams along with 200 milligrams of norethisterone. So this will inhibit spermatogenesis with a success of 97%. Because these are obviously progesterone drugs. So these will inhibit spermatogenesis, right? And then the fifth drug is desogestrel. This desogestrel, it has androgenic property. So it is given in 75 to 300 micrograms daily. Along with that, you can give subcutaneous pellets of testosterone in 300 mcg. Okay, this will cause oligospermia. Okay, so this is about desogestrel. So these are the different agents which will suppress spermatogenesis. So thank you guys for watching my lecture. In my next class, I'll explain about oral contraceptive pills. So thank you for watching my lecture. Thank you.